Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Birds Gymnasium here in Hamilton. Well, you might notice something a little different here in Hamilton tonight. A little different look around the court. It's the OUA Final Four. The pageantry is here. The signage is here. The sport court is here. It's the most important dress rehearsal we've had in this facility, as we'll be back here in a week's time for the CIS Championships. But before we do, Amanda, it's Ryerson and Queens in our first OUA semifinal here tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. Super excited to see these teams go head-to-head. You know, we've seen them in the Birds Gym against McMaster, but we have not seen them go against each other. Queens versus Ryerson, these are two huge teams, and they definitely deserve to be in the Final Four today.
Well, the Ryerson Rams have had Queens' number this season. Two matchups between the two teams, with Ryerson taking both of them. One set lost by the Rams in those two matches. And we'll see whether Queens can find an answer here at the Birds Gym as they look to book their own place at the CIS National Championships. Looking out at the teams here, and no surprise, Ivo Dramov at the libero spot for the Queens Golden Gales. Jamie Wright at setter. Of course, the big name for the Gales tonight will be Marco Dakic, the one-time outside hitter of the York Lions who transferred this season to Queens to take his law degree. And he's emerged as one of the top hitters in all the province.
Yeah, and it's absolutely no surprise. And saying big name is not something uncommon for him. This man stands 6'6 here on the court, and he is going to be a huge influence for this team tonight.
The team's about ready to get underway. Look out at a very regular lineup here for the Gales. Tomlinson, Dramov, Jamie Wright, Dakic, and Tyler Shearhorn in the middle. And on the opposite side, Rob Wojcik, the fifth-year veteran of the Rams. Adam Agnostopoulos, of course, former OUA Rookie of the Year at the setting controls. He will be a major player for the Rams tonight. Serve comes over and out wide this time, and the first touch of the night goes the way of the Ryerson Rams.
You know, this is what teams want to do, Frazier. Isolate that middle right from the get-go. In men's volleyball, it's very important to get those blockers moving, and for the Ryerson side to go through the middle with that quick play right off the bat, that's exactly what you want to do.
Fifth-year veteran Mark Reardon with the first point of the night as the Rams lead 1-0. Dramov forced a set here, out wide to Tomlinson. He's off balance, but he gets that over the block. And right into the block go the Rams. Recycled here to Agnostopoulos. And that is Uchenna Foa. An emotional point to the ground for the Rams as he beats the single.
You can see Dramov being kind of interesting on that set there. A libero by nature, but really good hands throwing it backwards. It's not something you can usually see here.
Reardon with the serve. Out wide to Tomlinson into the double block. And the point goes the way of the Rams. Just inside the boundary here.
Ofua really stretching some masculine nature there up in the front, looking across the net. It gets a bit street out here.
Some early emotion from the Rams. Ofua, of course, has really taken on a heightened role with this team as the season has progressed. And Dustin Reed has seen what he can do. And Ofoa yet again on the block as the Rams have taken this over on the defensive side.
Interesting step there, an interesting approach here on the Queens side. It looked like he went off of one foot, maybe didn't have enough time. Ball wasn't set high enough or off the net. Big block here in the front tees up against, though.
Queens struggling to find their rhythm early. And out of system they go again, but this time, an Anagostopoulos can't find Afoa through the middle on the quick. And Queens gets a nice, easy point, and they needed that badly.
It's funny, sometimes those are the ones you want to isolate. Middle goes up for it, you kind of want to throw people off. Agnostopoulos putting in a really sweet position, but Afoa maybe not going for it in terms of actually getting the hit, but just the theatrics of it all.
Out wide this time, and off balance is Wojcik. And into the block yet again. This is not a recording, as Chris Burnett finds Afoa. We'll have a look at that play momentarily. As Wojcik goes back to serve. This is the story of the set thus far. Afoa seals up the inner half of that block, and it's 5-1 Ryerson Rams. Out wide, and that's a bad touch. It's a double by Jamie Wright. And Queens trailing 5 points early. Rob Wojcik back to the service line yet again. Wojcik's serve buzzed over, up by Drama. Through the middle this time, and a better result for Marko Dakic, bringing in a little bit of athleticism in the pipe.
That power in the back, you want to have that opportunity from the back rows in the front, and that's what we got to love about this men's game here.
Back go the Queens Gales to the line. And out wide now, does that touch anyone? Lands inside. Does that attack?
You know, looking up here, we have our own DJ here in the bridge tonight. It looks like he's got a couple extra blockers because we're expecting some big things in the Final Four.
Well, when you bring the very best volleyball players in the province to the gym, you might expect a little bit more ferocity.
And that's what we just saw from Alex Dawson going up and just creaming a party ball right on the tape. You know, these guys are going to bring it every single chance that they get. You know, you flex a little bit, you give those opportunities, you throw over a free, they are going to take that with full regard, because this is what they're fighting for, is a chance and an opportunity to play in the Final Four championships. You know, Fraser, what are you not seeing here from the Queens Gales side?
Well, really shockingly bad passing from the Gales side of the net so far, making things very easy on the Rams. And to their credit, Ryerson, of course, really sealing things up on the block. They've been very organized defensively, and they're asking an awful lot of Queens right now.
Yeah, it just seems as though the Ryerson side has been very crisp. They've had very good back row passing. They've definitely flexed a little bit of muscle with Afoa in the front there, as well as Dawson. And I've been seeing some good things on the libero side, on the Queens roster. But I don't know, Dramoff, he needs to clean it up just a little bit.
Lucas Coleman at the service line. Spinner comes over. Up better this time by Dakic, and out wide. And Tomlinson brings the hammer down. He goes down the line and beats Afoa straight up.
Anytime we've ever called games with Queens in there, Tomlinson has always kind of flown under the radar until he's done something extremely big showing up later in the match. But it seems as though he's getting ready to go right off the top here.
Tomlinson back with the spin serve. Buzzed over, and that's an ace. And a massive celebration from Tomlinson. What a time for that play. As the Gales have emerged from this timeout with a bit more purpose. They trail 8-4 in this opening set. And that ace brings Brenda Willis out of the seat. Tomlinson again, spinner coming. And that one buzzes well long. Will Otten doesn't even look at it.
Another thing to note, it's always interesting when you step into a Final Four or a CIS match, as they have the clip court down tonight. That can always change a little bit in terms of your timing or where you're looking, because those extra lines on the court also add a little bit of insight.
This one goes to the floor courtesy of Scott Burnett. Of course, two Burnett brothers on this Queens roster. Scott and brother Chris, who we will likely see at some point tonight. As Anagnostopoulos attempts to save that ball with one hand and cannot do so. And Queens continues to climb back into this opening set. It's 9-6 Ryerson. as I mentioned, Chris Brunetti goes back to serve and pops one right into the tape. Curse of the commentator at work yet again, Amanda.
There you go. Always an interesting point in seeing Chris here on the court, as he is only a first year, yes, following up behind the footsteps of his brother with the Queen's Gills, but very interesting that he's making it onto the court as a first year. Really successful player this year.
Member of the all-rookie team this season in the OUA was
no
Scott
doubt.
Burnett. Sorry, Chris Burnett. I've already mixed them up. It's only the opening season. Back goes Anagnostopoulos to serve. Floater over. Up this time by Burnett and out wide to Tomlinson. And Otten can't save it in the back row. Tomlinson bringing the heat so far.
There we go. You know, that's what I said earlier. Tomlinson, he really knows how to bring the strength. When he goes up, he swings with no regard, and that's what he just did in the back row. Good to see that he can flex that power in the front and the back row.
You saw in that replay that Alex Dawson on the outside of that block from Ryerson gave a bit of space. It'll be interesting to see as this match goes on whether that changes. And as we mentioned that, Queens cleans up a loose ball. And they are within 3 points here. It's 11-8.
Reardon really getting shut down in the middle by those blockers. Seems like Agnostopoulos maybe wants to set him off a little bit more, as if he gets blocked, it's one of those things he's not very used to.
And the ace goes down, this time by Scott Burnett. Brenda Willis and the Queens bench erupt. Within 2 points are the Gales now, 11-9. And set through the pipe, but off balance are the Rams. Can the Gales use it? Out wide to Dakic. And he goes off hands and down. And it's a one-point set. Remarkable turnaround, given the way that this match started.
Really interesting defense there. You know, he goes up off the net. You're going to have Otten swing to the left there, having Dawson come in. It's always hard to see who's going to take that seam.
Up by Burnett and through the middle to Shearhorn. And he cuts that angle very well. I thought he'd been a little overambitious, Tyler Shearhorn, but he gets that call. Great angle chosen. It's 11 all.
Tomlinson again with a big smash right from the back there. You know, that back corner has been extremely vulnerable for Ryerson in this match thus far, and the tables have turned. Queens is now up by one. They were being defeated pretty quickly at the beginning of that set, but is now 12-11, and the Ryerson Rams have called a timeout.
Well, remarkable turnaround by the Rams, or by the Queens Gales, sorry, as Brenda Willis called that timeout, trailing 5 points early, and has really settled this roster down, and as we mentioned, the passing has improved by leaps and bounds, Meta.
Yeah, absolutely. And it seems as though Otten is maybe being beat left to right a little bit. They need to clean up those seams, get those defensive balls. It seems as though the Queens Gales have managed to clean up their offense enough to make a move, and it's now Ryerson that is making the mistakes.
Well, the teams retake court here.
Scott Burnett takes the stage as the Ryerson Rams try to throw him off of his serving run here.
A little extended break here on court as the Rams reposition themselves. Serve comes over and up this time by Otten. Anastopoulos out wide to Wojcik. And he goes straight through the block. That was two sets of hands in front of him. But Shearhorn cannot get the best Wojcik on that occasion. Of course, this is Wojcik's last tournament here. And he's seen a Ryerson team that's been close, but hasn't really gotten over the hump in the last number of years. Couldn't make a final. He'd love to do so this week. We dive back into live action here. And Tomlinson out of the back row. Does he find court? He does.
You know, out of that timeout, Ryerson Rams probably planning, you know, let's do something simple, let's do something clean, throw it out to Wojcik, he gets a big kill. Queens retaliating with their hot hand right now. Tomlinson just absolutely going up and smashing it again from the outside.
Serve over this time, and up by Agnostopoulos. Out wide, and that's Wojcik. He beats the block of Dakic. That'll be a tough matchup
for the Queens Gales. That catches many things, but he's not really all that tall, and as a blocker, sometimes preyed upon.
Oh, absolutely. And you see Wojcik go up. You know, that's just a testament to his athleticism. You see that cut shot right in front of the tee. That just is fabulous play.
And a great one-handed save by the Rams, who will have to deal with a free, and they can't get it over. Lucas Coleman with the final touch. Couldn't contend with the net. ...14-13 here. As the Gales go back to serve. Spinner over by Dakic. And a ace, another gigantic ace by the Queens Gales, and suddenly bringing their power to bear here in this first set.
You know, you gotta love the way that the Queens Gales have been managing those aces. Really, they've been going straight down the line, taking those seams to turn the passers' bodies outside of the court.
Out wide this time to Coleman, and he beats the block. Goes directly at Tomlinson, and Shearhorn on the double. So we're a little bit late.
Grimov really taking that one off the chin, eh?
The life of a libero is not glamorous.
No, it is not. Mad respect.
Back goes Wojcik to the line, and he flubs the serve into the net. And the Queens bench that was letting him know about it will continue that noise as we enter the technical timeout here.
You know, you gotta love the way that these players are really, really taking this so seriously. You see Dramov come off, and he's still probably carrying a little bit of the weight of that last pass that he missed. Brenda Willis look at him saying, it's okay, you know, you can do this, because she kind of realizes that these guys are gonna be as tough as on themselves as she could ever be.
Well, looking at players on court here, and as you might expect, the usual names for the Queens Gales have showed up in this first set. 4 points for Marco Dakic, and 5 for Tomlinson, as Queens has really begun to lean on their star players and refine that system.
It seems as though they weren't affected or fazed by anything that was happening in the beginning of the set. They just needed to kind of get the engine started, throw Tomlinson the ball, be successful on the baseline. That's what they've done. They've had a couple aces. They've had some kills that have absolutely been lights out. And if they can continue that play, if Dramov can continue to show up in the defensive position, then I think these guys are standing in a pretty good position for the set.
Tyler Shearhorn back to the line here for the Gales, as they look to get us started here following the technical. Floater over by Shearhorn, and that finds only tape. Ryerson will take that side out gladly after the timeout. Coleman back with the spinner, and he just misses the back line. Great call by Dramov and the Queens Gales to bail out in front of that ball. A gutsy call.
Yeah, absolutely. That ball just went out by a couple of inches there. Always hard to tell on a spinner.
Tomlinson back to serve now for the Gales. Spinner over.
Dawson just picks it up like it was nothing.
Great up by Dawson, and he gets the ball back on the seat. Dust it up.
You gotta love those plays because they really remind you of Beach. Dawson just pops it up for a setter, goes outside, hits it. Gotta love that.
Absolutely a beachy play from a team that has several prominent beach players on it. Back go the Rams. Float serve over. And into a joust, and that goes the way of the Rams. Great touch that time at the net by Mark Reardon.
Always a debatable call. If you can get your setter in there and you get right with his hands on it, that push over the top would have gone the way of the Queens Gills.
Brandon Jordan back to serve yet again. Floater over. Out wide this time to Tomlinson. He goes over the block, and he beats Wojcik on the cut shot. 18-17 Queens, and Ofoa will check back in for the Rams. Out comes Jordan.
I gotta say, Tomlinson is absolutely on fire today.
Tomlinson looking very good, and of course, if you look back at this matchup through the regular season, Mike Tomlinson was really conspicuously absent from many of those matches. If he can get going this match as he is in this set, Queens could be on fire. The Rams bring us back level here. It's 18-all in the opening set. And Agnostopoulos back to serve. Not much to choose between these teams right now, Amanda. Floater over. Up this time by Dakic. And set out the back to Tomlinson. And he goes into the block and wide. He tools that block.
It seems as though his strategy right now is just to go out fully blazing. You know, he's not taking any regard for that block. He has no respect here. Just absolutely going straight for it, hoping that he can tool these guys, which he just was successful in doing.
Agnostopoulos tight to the net, was able to set that back, and we remain in rally play here. And an up by Coleman finds the basketball net here at the Birds Gym. Brings that rally to an end. 20-18, Queens just 5 points away, remarkably, after the way this set began. Burnett again with the serve. Not well handled by Auden. Out wide to Wojcik, who tips over the block, and a great pancake by Tomlinson. Set through the middle this time, and a point for Reardon. He thought he'd overcooked it. You could actually see him respond like he'd mishit the ball. He takes down the point regardless.
As soon as you hit that ball, you know that something is up, and you know he just kissed that baseline. I think Queens tried to throw up some theatrics there to convince the referees likewise.
Back go the Gales here. 21-19, they lead. Jamie Wright, the setter, back to serve. Brenda Willis is up and animated, as you might expect at this juncture. Ball out wide to Wojcik, off hands, and Marco Dakic right in front of us, just exhorting himself to get his hands around that ball.
Wow, this game is certainly getting close, 21-20, and each set is going to be worth more than the last, but the first definitely sets the precedent.
Libero and outside here, Wesley Kosiba, defensive specialist, is in as a spot server for Reardon. Floater over, and out wide here, into hands goes Dakic. Out wide now to Tomlinson. He tips over the block and a save, but to no avail as Agnostopoulos misses the sideline. It's 22-20.
You know, in playing volleyball and watching coaches and seeing what they want when they get a tip, they always say you want to go up the same way. You want to convince them that you're going after that big swing. Tomlinson has proven that he's strong in doing that. So when he goes up for that tip and he plays it off like that little touch there, it's kind of funny to watch him try to make that adjustment.
Well, 22-20, and of course, anyone set left to win here, but Queen is just 3 points away, and Ryerson forced to call time. And Amanda, in such a tight set, what do you think will be the factor that really elevates one team over the other, takes us to the second?
You know, right now it seems as though serve-receive isn't too bad on either side. It's really all about defense at this point and making those serves. You know, both these teams have been pretty successful on the serving line, haven't seen too many errors. Sometimes in the men's game it goes back and forth quite a bit. But it's going to be strength on that baseline, getting in play, and just giving it to your opponent to make that mistake.
Well, the teams have retaken court here. The Gales go back to serve. And it's Dakic with the spinner. Great up this time by Auden, saved by Anaxopoulos. And over the block goes the Rams. Into a block and recycled here. Out wide to Tomlinson and popped over. Saved by Wojcik and out wide to Coleman. He beats the block and he will not get hands called as he misses long. 23-20.
You know, it's hard to believe that a block that big can be missed, but it sure was. And you can tell by the way it just flew out the back.
Purely an attack meant to find hands, but he could not. Dakic goes back to serve yet again. Spinner over and really eats up the Rams. They're out of system here and tight to the net. But a great save by Coleman on that out of system ball. Goes through the block and down. 23-21. We're really being treated to a set that we would expect here at the Final Four. Top quality volleyball and not much to choose.
Absolutely.
Wojcik back to serve, and the spinner goes into the tape at an agonizing time. 24-21 and three set points for the Queens Gales.
Definitely tough to watch. You see Dakic go back that point before, really just giving it full strength. But to miss a ball right now, 24-21, can make all the difference.
out wide to Wojcik, and he puts that one to the floor. Right in front of the Burnett brothers, acting as a blocking tandem, but they're a little bit late. 24-22, the Rams live to fight another point here in set one. Lucas Coleman with the spinner coming. Up by Burnett and out wide to him. And right through the block goes Burnett. And the Gales take the opening set, 25-22 here at the Burridge, overcoming a slow start. And it's all Queens at the moment. And Amanda, before we get into our analysis, we want to kick it to our new member of the crew here, sideline reporter Kyle, who's got some opinions from the coaches.
Thanks, guys. As you can see here in the Burridge Gym, the floor is different. They use the sports court for this Final Four tournament. As you can see, it's a lot better for volleyball. It's very shock absorbent and a lot better on your body compared to the hard court they use for basketball. And I talked to both coaches, both coaching staffs before this match, and they said this game's going to come down to big serves and who's going to be more aggressive. As you could see in that set towards the end, Ryerson missed a big serve. So the Queens coach said it's going to come down to that. And I talked to the Ryerson coaching staff, and they said stay in the moment. Forget the regular season, even though they beat Queens twice. So you'll see here, great first set. More to come. Back to you guys at the desk.
Thank you, Kyle. And as we return here to the table, we'll go through a little bit of a highlight package. Man, we're seeing really two teams swinging freely on one another.
Absolutely.
Big, powerful kills from both teams.
Definitely a good analysis there from Kyle that it is going to come down to strength on the baseline, and it also comes down to strength up at the net here.
Of course, we saw Mike Tomlinson with a fantastic pancake dig in this highlight pack, and Tomlinson has really emerged as one of Queen's top players this season, and he's really showing it tonight as Queen's has brought their A game from their stars.
Absolutely, and you know what we're seeing from Tomlinson right now is just extreme athleticism. As well as I would say, Wojcik is also giving us that. You know, they're really throwing out the mental game right now. They're just absolutely going with full regard for the game. They want to take this one. Both sides having super strong players, and you know it just comes out to leaving it all on the court. And that is definitely a testament to him getting that pancake, him throwing it all on the court when he goes up for a swing. And going under the analysis that sometimes it is going to take the tip, sometimes it is going to take the swing. You know, that's just a senior player at work.
Well, Marco Dakic, of course, a player that we talked about in the pregame, a player that is so necessary for this Queens team. Not the greatest opening set from him. Two kills, two errors on seven attempts, but of course, service ace and defensively responsible as well, a very physically active, fit player in the backcourt.
Yeah, absolutely. And back to that service ace, too. Not only does he have a service ace, but he has no service errors, which can be very big in the men's game to just get things going and allow the other team to make the mistakes.
Well, looking out at these two teams and the same roster that we saw to begin this match returns here for set number two. It's the Burnett brothers, Mike Tomlinson, Marco Dakic, Ivo Dramov, and Tyler Shearhorn with Jamie Wright setting for the Queens Gales. And on the opposite side, Lucas Coleman, Rob Wojcik, Reardon, and Otten, and the setter, and Agnostopoulos, of course.
Agnostopoulos, no surprise, starting in one here, getting his big hitters right in the front. Definitely a huge call.
Jamie Wright this time through the middle, as Shearhorn brings down the first point of the set for the Gales. And Amanda, when Queens was here to play McMaster earlier in this semester, Tyler Shearhorn really emerged. He was a big presence for the Gales, and I wonder if we'll see more of Tyler Shearhorn as this match develops. Great save this time by Agnostopoulos, close to the net, out wide to Wojcik. Queens back in system, and Dakic off hands. Otten forced a bump set here, and it's a free ball, and Queens use it. Out wide this time to Dakic, off-speed ball, saved by Agnostopoulos to no one.
You know, I completely agree on your point that you just made about the Queen's Gales, getting Shearhorn involved here. You know, we didn't see him a ton in that first set, but it was all because serve receive was a little bit off. Maybe they couldn't run the middle as sufficiently. Maybe they were just throwing it to Tomlinson, who is the hot hand. But if they can get Shearhorn involved, I think we'll definitely see a larger split.
Reardon into a block this time and out wide to Tomlinson. And he beats Wojcik and Otten on the receive. Gales with a red hot start to this second set.
You know, Dremov is going to want to be careful there. He did do a bit of a jump set in front of the attack line. He wants to make sure that he doesn't take the ball over the crease of the net or else that's a violation.
Back into play here, and Shearhorn goes right into the block of Reardon, who takes down a much needed point for the Rams with momentum really purely in Queen's favor to begin this second set.
You know, by design, that kind of makes sense that the Queen's Gales would be going out to Tomlinson if they can get him hot and heavy quick, because Reardon and Shearhorn are up against each other, and Reardon is a little bit larger than Shearhorn, which makes him a little more difficult to carve around that block.
Back goes Dakic to serve here for the Gales. Big spinner coming. Up and over goes the spin serve. Otten saves it, but right into a free ball, and somehow the pinball game continues. Out wide this time to Burnett, who tips over. And Otten will be forced to set. Coleman off the block and down as he beats Shearhorn. And it's 4-2, the Gales lead here in set two.
Very good organization and communication on the Ryerson side. Coleman backs up huge out of that to make that out-of-system ball a successful one.
Ryerson Rams with the side out, and Reardon goes back to serve. Pops over the floater. Up this time by Dakic. Set out wide to Burnett into a block and saved by Dremov. Tomlinson this time over the block, and a great one-handed up by the setter, Anagnostopoulos. Dakic through the pipe into the block, and Lucas Coleman celebrates. He brings down the pivotal touch there.
You know, celebration absolutely goes out to Anagnostopoulos on the outside. One-handed dig on, and all the guys on the court here pause. Because, you know, he's their guy. They all look at each other and say, holy, it's time for us to get going.
Yeah, you might not want Adam Anagnostopoulos to get hurt with those precious hands. As the ball goes wide to Tomlinson, and he beats the block this time. That's a FOA with the loose hands on the interior of the block. 5-3 Queens. The elder Burnett checks back in, and Dremov checks back out. Shearhorn with the float serve. Up this time and out wide. And Coleman just pops over the block. And he tees off. Lucas Coleman tees off. Sorry, that last touch went to Wojcik. And Lucas Coleman polishes off the party ball. Wojcik back to serve. Ryerson within a point here in the second, having dropped the opening set. And that's an ace. That is an ace for the veteran, Rob Wojcik, at a perfect time.
Hard to believe that it's only 5-5 here right now in the gym. Seems as though we've been watching this set for a little bit, and that just goes to show that we've had some pretty good rallies within this one.
These players are definitely tiring themselves out here on night number one. And that is a return ace for Rob Wojcik. He is causing all sorts of chaos for the receive pattern of the Queen's Gales.
Maybe a little redemption for that 23rd serve miss in the last set.
Yeah, that one will stick with him for a while, and he's definitely paying it down right now. Wojcik again, and that is a third ace in a row for Rob Wojcik. And you wonder, will Brenda Willis call it? And she does. Timeout for the Gales, who cannot deal with the service ace of Rob Wojcik.
Always a debate there as Wojcik gets these two big aces, gets really excited, and sometimes that adds the adrenaline, and then they'll miss their next serve. Brenda Willis almost giving him the opportunity to settle down and reset on that service line.
Well, all of a sudden, the Ryerson Rams have some energy, and you felt like this was a really necessary stretch of play for them. For the Rams to really fall behind here in set number two, having lost set number one, it really would have been a hole to dig themselves out of.
Absolutely. And, you know, we've talked about this before in season OUA, how important that second set is. You know, it either evens the stage or it sets a precedent to just seal the deal on the third. And this is what the Ryerson Rams realized. This is what Dustin Reed, head coach of the team, realizes. And it's now or never. These guys have got to bring it or just leave it all.
Well, after what he might have deemed a quiet first set, Rob Wojcik now with 7 points for the Rams after this 3-point spread from the service line. He pumps another bullet of a serve directly at Marko Dekic. And that's 4 aces in 4 serves for the fifth-year senior. What a wild period of play this is.
Yeah, you look up. It's early in the second set. This guy already has 8 points on the board.
Back goes Wojcik again. And the serve this time mercifully long as the Gales leave it alone. They can't handle it. Might as well hope that it lands long. 8-6, the Rams lead after that transformative service run from Rob Wojcik.
Another strong server here on the baseline. Tomlinson going for his top spin.
Spinner up and over, and that eats up the Rams. And suddenly, it's an ace party.
You know, it's funny, Tomlinson often goes at Dawson here, and he usually picks it up pretty well, but the strength and the spin may have thrown him off a little bit.
You wonder if that's something that Brenda Willis saw in scouting. Queens really has gone at Alex Dawson today. And Tomlinson misses that one. And Ryerson sides out. And will we see some rally play as Ryerson takes over at the line? Of course, another heavy server taking over. It's Lucas Coleman.
You know, really seeing some strength from Lucas Coleman, not only on the baseline, but also up on the offense.
Tight to the net, and the joust is won by the Rams. And Queens out of system here. Great get by Dawson. Sorry, by Wojcik. And then Coleman mishandles that ball.
Really tough. He kind of didn't watch the set before it formulated and overran that one a little bit. Reaching back didn't give him enough strength to put that one over the net.
Of course, on this sport court, it's very easy to identify the attack line.
Definitely.
Through the middle to Afoa, and not saved for long by the Gales. Dramoff did what he could to elongate that play. But 10-8, the Rams lead.
It seems like Afoa and Agnostopoulos have really figured out their own timing, these two. He really elevated him to use his full arm length on that one.
Afoa back to serve, the floater over and misses. Good eye by the Gales on the back line.
They definitely called it before it even went over the seam of the net there.
Gutsy play, but again, that's what it takes. You don't want to play needless volleyball. Up by Otten, tight to the net, and Agnostopoulos goes for the dump. It ties up the Queens Gales, and it's a free ball. Out wide this time to Dawson, off hands, and saved by Chris Burnett. Off hands and through the block. Tomlinson continues to be Mr. Reliable on the outside.
Like you said, Tomlinson already with 12 points to himself.
Up by Otten, but not well. And a great set by Agnostopoulos. Dawson dusts it off. You can see why Adam Agnostopoulos has been statistically the most productive setter in the province every year of his career.
Absolutely. Not only does he have good placement, but he is really athletic and very quick when he goes to set up his players.
Dekic could not handle that serve, and it's saved by Burnett, but not well. Out wide as Otten watches that one to the floor.
That one kind of makes you furrow your brows a little bit. I mean, these guys in the OUA final, and they're just putting a free ball over, and it goes out.
Zach Hutchison comes into the match for Dekic. Interesting call here as the star Dekic checks out. Up this time by Hutchison, out wide, and that's Tomlinson through the attempted block of Reardon and Dawson. You can see Dawson not happy with himself after that one.
I'd love to see how many balls Tomlinson has actually hit right into the block and been successful on.
Well, until they can seal it up, he'll continue to get what he wants from that play. As Reardon tries to go to the floor and Dramoff with a great up. And it's Hutchison, his first point of the match. welcome to the Final Four, rookie.
Definitely an exciting moment for any rookie to step into a Final Four.
Serve up this time from Jamie Wright, the setter. Out wide now and well long by Dawson. Rams seem to be looking for a touch there. Appeal to the referee, who was having none of it. 13-12. The Gales lead here in set two, having, of course, taken the opening set. Wojcik over the block, and he gets the point somehow, carves that inside court. I think Queens thought that was their point, had huddled up in celebration. Not so fast, gentlemen. Dawson back to serve. Spinner over and not well handled. That's right off the hands of the rookie Hutchison.
You know, it just goes to show how important these moments are. You know, in that first set, Ryerson actually had a higher hitting percentage than Queens did, but Queens still managed to take the match as they had four aces in the first set and Ryerson had none. So it's definitely important to keep in mind how important the attack from that baseline is.
Well, a costly service error here from Dawson in a very tight second set. It's 14-all, and Hutchison back to serve. Hutchison over, up by Otten, and through the middle to Reardon. Dug up well by Hutchison and out wide. Burnett into a block, dug up by Drama. Out wide this time to Tomlinson, into the antenna. And that's a point for the Rams. And you can see the Ryerson bench get up, very excited by the play of their team, really extending that rally, Amanda.
Absolutely, and you know, that really was a great set here on the outside by Wright, but just a little bit too far, and Tomlinson's just going up with no regard, so maybe not seeing that antenna on the outside.
Reardon with the float serve, up by Drama. Out wide this time to Tomlinson into a block, but Afoa can't keep it under control, into his chest and down. 15-all. One of these teams is about to take us into the technical. Back to serve are the Gales. Floater over. Up by Otten. Out wide here to Coleman. And he beats the block of Tomlinson. And if you're going to give Lucas Coleman a loose block like that, he'll eat it right up.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't know. It's the build of Coleman. He's very, very strong, gentlemen. You would kind of underestimate him. Maybe his height is a little bit lower than a couple of the other players here on the offense. But this guy can jump, and he definitely brings strength behind any ball that he hits. And he's definitely shown that within this game thus far.
Well, Coleman with 7 points listed here on the board at the Birds. Jim, of course, Rob Wojcik with 9 after that large service run he had to begin this second set. But Amanda, it really is great to see that the star players that we bank on in events like this have come to play tonight.
Absolutely, and you know, watching these two teams come head-to-head, 16-15 here in the Bridge, very well-matched game. You've got some great middles in the middle here. Both setters are very strong, both liberos going head-to-head on those defense plays. And you know, I can't really determine which team deserves to win this set more. You know, they're both so well-matched.
It really is a difficult one to call at this stretch. You really would feel that either team deserved the set at this moment, and yet neither one deserves to lose. And as we often say on this booth, it really will come down to execution, inches in the final points here of this second set.
Absolutely, and talking on that, Wojcik comes to the baseline. Let's see if he can get that ace serving run as he did last rotation.
Yeah, danger rotation here for the Gales. Spinner over, dealt with this time by the Gales, and out wide to Tomlinson out of system. He pops over, out wide now, and that's into the net, no touch on the shot by Wojcik.
Agnostopoulos is going to need to reestablish that front row here. You know, going to Wojcik could have been a good choice, but, you know, he really was set up in the front row. You don't want to discourage your players in the front row like Ofoa. You want to keep them going. You want to keep them strong. You have Coleman on the outside. You don't need to throw it to the back.
Also beginning to really cheat to the outside is Agnostopoulos. Got to keep this team on it. Meanwhile, Tomlinson back to serve, and he misses wide. We got a great look at Lucas Coleman watching that ball straight to the floor. Eyes directly on his fries, as Tim Lukes might say.
A Timism. The women's coach of the McMaster team often pulling out some special little sayings.
Back to serve goes Coleman, and he flubs that one right into the net.
Holy cow, did he ever.
Yeah, the only one in danger of touching that ball was his teammate in the front row. And it's Burnett's turn at the service line. Floater over, up by Otten. Set through the middle to Afoa. And he beats Scott Burnett on that play. And I wonder if we'll see that more often as this match progresses. Afoa checks out. Jordan checks back in as the spot server. Jordan back with the float serve. Nice and steady and up by Dramoff. And through the middle this time. And Burnett takes it down.
Brierson really playing their defense a little high here, expecting these guys to hit right on the attack line. But you know what? As we just saw, if they can get that back third, they're going to be very successful, as the Queens Gales have been.
Fifth-year senior Scott Burnett back to serve now for the Gales. Up by Otten. Set out wide here to Dawson into hands. Recycled this time by Hutchison and out wide to Tomlinson. And he beats that block.
Another
again,
one.
Right through Broadway.
Another one. You know, Dustin Reed is really going to have to look at these guys and say, you know, it's time to press, it's time to look at each other, it's time to call when you guys go up together, because it's making it very difficult for the defense on the Ryerson side.
You have to say, in this tight set, that may be the difference. The Ryerson side, really, the inability to just technically execute on blocks.
Yeah, absolutely. We say this often. The game is won right at that blocking opportunity on the defense and on these serves.
19 all here, second set. Tight to the net goes that party ball and saved by Dramoff, and this will come over on the free. Can Ryerson use it? Out wide to Dawson. Off hands and up by Dramoff. Wide this time to Hutchison and dug up well by Otten. Through the pipe goes Coleman with the tip. Out wide again to Hutchison into a block. But it goes wide. And that point goes the way of the Gales, even though Ryerson looked like they had it locked up.
Absolutely. Really good scrappy play here. You know, you can't expect anything. Angstopoulos throwing it outside very high, making Dawson wait a little while. If they can speed up this offense, they'll catch the Queen Gales a little bit with their pants down.
Well, a great save by Will Otten on that serve off the tape. And his teammates reward him. In-system ball and a quick middle kill.
There we go, Frazier. Just a little quicker play. That's all I'm saying. That's all I want.
20 all here. Second set up by Dramoff. And out wide to Tomlinson. Great cut shot, but up by Otten. And a Statue of Liberty saved by Anagnostopoulos. Hutchison forced to give the free. And out wide now to Coleman. Off hands. Up by Dramoff. Tomlinson with the tip. And alert to it is Anagnostopoulos. Wide to Coleman, off hands and down, and a great defensive point is rewarded.
You know, that's what it's all about, getting those defensive plays and making something of it. And Coleman has definitely been making something out of a lot of things this set.
We get a look at the last touch of that long rally and some great defense out of the backcourt. Setter Anagnostopoulos really the star on that play as Queens deals with a heavy spin serve. Free ball over. Wide this time to Wojcik into the block. Saved by Dramoff one-handed. And wide, that's Hutchison who misses. Suddenly 22-20, and Ryerson poised to try to level this match. Well, back comes Marco Dakic as Hutchison checks out. So the star outside is back into the match. Up this time by Dakic. Back to him on the seat. Over the block and dug up well. Out of system are the Gales. High ball into a block. And that one is just wide. A little loose yet again on the block, Amanda.
This is that moment. Dakic comes in maybe a little cold after being off. This is that defining moment, a very, very important moment in this set as he goes to the baseline to bring his team back up into the positives.
Dakic with the spinner. He takes a lot off of it, up by Coleman, back to him, and a great up by Dramoff. Backing up the solo block. Great save by Lucas Coleman as Otten puts over the free. Set out wide this time to Burnett into a block, and he can't bring it back as the Gales try to play pinball. It's 23-21, Ryerson on the bird.
Queens better watch out, because it looks like Ryerson just learned how to block.
That really has been the difference, and if Ryerson can seal up that part of their game, look out. West Coast Siva comes back into the match here. Spot server Wesley Kosiva. Dusting off the boots. Floater over. Up by Dramov. Tight to the net, and Wright can't save it. And Tomlinson puts that ball into the chest of his opponent after the whistle.
I don't think he minded taking that one off the chest. It seemed to pump him up a little bit more.
Ryerson coaching staff not too pleased with that. Some words for the referee here at set point, 24-21. Saved by Dramov. Out of system to Burnett. And Agnostopoulos with the bump set. And Coleman off balance. Clubs that into the net.
What an intention, though. Coleman going up. Agnostopoulos really saving that one high ball. Coleman seeing that front cut shot. As there was no one there. Blockers vacated completely. So great intention. But you're right. You need that execution.
Tyler Shearhorn here for the Queens Gales. Two more set points for them to dodge. And a stoppage in play. As the referees have to discuss the rotation.
Shearhorn maybe getting a bit of that vuvuzela in his ear.
Yeah, you can hear the vuvuzelas here. Of course, 1,000 of them were ordered in anticipation of the CIS Championship. We might all be without eardrums by the end of next week. Floater over this time by Shearhorn. Out wide to Coleman, into the antenna. And another dodge set point by the Queens Gales.
And this is what it all comes down to, the ability to seal a set. And you know, we've been here before watching the women's game last weekend. They actually had a set go all the way up to 36-34. So anything can happen.
Rewatching that match this week, and I couldn't believe some of the points that we saw. As we look at some highlights here from this long extended set, these two teams going out with one another. And of course, the loose blocks.
Tomlinson just absolutely crushing it through some loose blocks there.
Wow, this really has been the story of the set for the Rams. But as we say that, some great recovery, great late play by the Rams, and they still remain poised to level this match. As the teams retake court here after the timeout.
Shearhorn, no pressure here on the baseline. 24-23 for the Ryerson Rams.
And touched by Lucas Coleman for no reason whatsoever.
Oh, man.
That ball.
You could hear the crowd with the, because they knew it was going out. Everyone in this gym knew it was going out, except for Coleman, unfortunately.
Three set points have gone wasted by the Ryerson Rams as Shearhorn touches the net with that serve. And Afoa puts it to the floor to bring his team a fourth set point. As the hunt for this set goes on. Really makes me wonder why Agnostopoulos hasn't gone to a four more often. Really has been successful when he has gotten that quick play.
Agreed.
Logic back to serve here. Spinner coming. It's over and up by Dramov. Wide to Tomlinson. And this is an anticlimactic way to end this second set as the Gales are called on the double contact. And the Ryerson Rams level this match at a set apiece, 26-24. And Amanda, before we get into our analysis here, our sideline reporter Kyle has a few thoughts of his own.
Thanks, guys. As you saw, Adam Agnostopoulos has been playing fantastic in this match, but it's to no surprise as he's been one of the best setters, not even in the OUA, but in all of Canada. His numbers, as he has 744 assists and averages 10.94 assists per set, he's first in the OUA, and he's third with those numbers in all of Canada. He also has 79 digs and 30 blocks this year, but he's done this his whole career. This is his third year on the Rams, and he's been starting since his first year as he has 2,004 assists over his career and his time with the Ryerson Rams. And if you just watch him play, he's very consistent. His presence on the court is very strong. He's that leader you need. always strong in the back row and with the set. So we've had a great match so far. So back to you guys at the desk with the third set.
And as you mentioned, Kyle, Adam Anagnostopoulos has been a real leader for this team. Of course, OUA Rookie of the Year in his first season, and really the setter of choice, no contender in sight for the Ryerson Rams.
Absolutely, no surprise there. You know, these guys have been having a very good match here. Kyle, you're absolutely right. And as we look at the stat sheet here, we see a little bit of a difference from the baseline. Ryerson men coming forth with 7 aces, 9 errors. And in the first set, they had 0 aces, 4 errors. So that just goes to show 5 aces in 1 set, only 4 errors. That's a pretty big difference.
We say it all the time, Amanda. The service line really is an ability to either push the opponent or really hurt yourself. You can do so much damage or you can do so much good. And the Ryerson Rams really changed that balance in set two.
Absolutely, and really a tough call to go out on that that missed set by Wright on the Queens Gales side. You know, Dramov was up at the upper F for a while debating what that call was all about, and it's always a really tough call there from the ref staff here, but standing strong on that call will earn you respect within the game, and these guys have definitely earned their respect up on the reffing side.
Well, it's always interesting to see what team comes out first as a new set dawns, and this time it's the Queens Gales. No real changes to their personnel. The Burnett brothers out here alongside Jamie Wright at setter. Tomlinson, Dramov at libero. Marco Dakic remains in this match after coming out of that second set for quite a long time. Shearhorn through the middle. And as we look at the other side, Will Otten at libero, and Anagnostopoulos at setter. Wojcik, Coleman on the left side, Dawson at power, and of course, Afoa through the middle alongside Reardon, who will, I would assume, switch off here for Otten.
As you said, definitely would be interested to see if there are going to be more middles going through on the Ryerson side, as Afoa was very successful anytime he got the ball. That'll all boil down to serve receive, that'll all boil down to defense, and whether Anagnostopoulos can really be confident in that set.
The setter, Jamie Wright, back to serve here for the Gales to get us started in set number three. And no surprise here, given how competitive these two teams have been all night, we're going to go to some bonus volleyball. It's the third set, and we're poised for at least 4. 1-1 overall. As the referees debate the lineup cards here. Of course, I'd also expect the referees are a little stricter here at this stage.
Oh, yeah. You know, they're not going to let anyone get away with anything. Like I said before, I always wish that the lines on the volleyball court would light up if it actually hit the line or went out, and it doesn't happen, so these guys have to really make that call.
Back goes right to the service line, and the floater over, up by Otten. Set wide this time, and that's Dawson. Goes right at Mike Tomlinson and takes down the first point.
I'm always interested to see whether a side of the court actually does you good or does you bad, because it seems as though both of those teams won on the technical home side of this court tonight. So we'll see if they'll be able to keep that flow on the Ryerson guest side.
Amanda, of course, a believer in the ghost of the Birds gym. I wonder how the ghost approves of the sport court, as Tyler Shearhorn takes down a point here for the Gales on the quick. And of course, great eye, Amanda, bringing up that middle attack, and we see it. Jamie Wright in system, perfect pass, brought down.
You gotta love it. Establishing that middle right from the beginning, and Jamie Wright is no slump to this game, and he knows that's exactly what he needs to do.
Dakic with a great spinner up by Otten. Out wide this time, and some complaints from the Queens side on a little bit of a messy touch. But play goes on. Through the pipe go the Rams, and a great up by the setter, Jamie Wright. Out wide this time to Tomlinson off hands. And set out back to Dawson, and he goes down off the hands of Shearhorn. Some great rally play here to get us started in set three. And Brenda Willis is letting the referees know what she thinks.
Yeah, Dramova absolutely wants to go over there and make a mention of it, as that's how they lost that last set. They want to make sure they're getting the equal calls here. However, as we wait, Dawson is on the baseline ready to go. You know, Dawson, one of those players I kind of take for granted. I've never really been like, yeah, Dawson's, he's like super great, super strong. But you know what? He is such a great dynamic player. Watching him today, so strong, so confident, so dynamic. I really, really enjoying watching him play.
One of those players that you feel might get buried on a roster with as many athletes and as much talent as Ryerson. But of course, Amanda, bringing down that last point that we saw, Dawson very much a member of that starting rotation.
Nothing to take for granted here.
Well, 3-2 for the Ryerson Rams. As we get some changes on the floor, libero's check back out on one side and back in on the other. Dramov in and Auden out as the serve goes into the tape. And right after I mentioned great rally play, we get some messy stuff.
A little flub. Here we go. Tomlinson on the back line. No worry, Frazier. There'll be a bit more strength in this serve, I bet.
Tomlinson with that great red beard going on. Tomlinson with the serve coming. Great spinner up. And Agnostopoulos tight. And he sets the near side, and Coleman goes off the block. And what a great high ball from Adam and Agnostopoulos.
Coleman really getting some power out of that first serve he received and then going outside and clearing it all up all on his own.
You can really speak to it, Amanda, as a former setter. It's so tough when you're right up against the net like that.
Oh, yeah.
To keep body control, keep that ball angled.
You know, often what you do as a setter is you run to it, you get your feet under it as quickly as possible, and the goal is to kind of turn your shoulders away so you're not going to be leaning into the net at all. But Agnostopoulos, he's just so dynamic and so quick, and he really has control over his body. You'll never really see that happen. He does so well tight to the net.
Chris Burnett with the serve, and it goes into system, and Agnostopoulos finds a foa as Ryerson sides out here. And surprise, surprise, we're back in a one-point set here in set three.
That's just it, eh, Frazier? Surprise, surprise. These two teams, as we've been saying throughout this whole match, they're so equally matched. And you're right, we're only going to expect a one-point split when watching these two teams.
Well, there's a reason that we schedule a two-and-a-half-hour delay between the beginning of the first match and the start of the second. We do expect some tight volleyball here at the Burridge as the Rams take down the point. Marco Dakic again trying to campaign for it. That one goes off his hands and wide.
You can tell the energy and the emotion is really raising here in the Burridge. More people are coming in to watch the game, and on every point and every big hit like that, the team kind of comes together stronger than ever.
Coleman buzzes the net. Up this time by Burnett, and that's a free ball. Into system are the Rams. And out wide to Dawson, a great save by Dramov. Dakic off hands in the front row, and that's not coming back, and that is all Ivo Dramov on the save. Getting down low to his right, controlling that ball. And Dakic put a lot of pace into it. Scott Burnett back to serve. Floater over, up by Auden. Through the pipe this time is Coleman. And this point goes the way of the Gales as Coleman's called on the attack line.
He really did fly forward there, even a foot under the half line there as he finished that swing.
Dangerous play for all involved at the net. Meanwhile, out wide here to Dawson. Did that touch hands? It did, according to the referee. Again, the Queen's Gale is doing an awful lot of chirping at this juncture. Dramov checks back in, and he's got his hands up as if to say, why?
Why? You know, it's really interesting to see the strength that Dawson can get even when his shoulders are completely away from the net. Just really strong shoulders there.
A foa with the float serve into the net. Costly one for his team as it levels the set here at 7 apiece. And a foa checks back out. Will Auden back into this match. Setter Jamie Wright back to serve. Up by Auden and out through the middle. And a great shot there by Reardon. Perfect pass on the quick. Setter Anagnostopoulos goes back to serve. His team leads 8-7 here in set number two. Set number three, sorry. Ahead of myself. Shearhorn over. Out of system are the Rams. Into the block and popped over on a free. Agnostopoulos with a great set out wide. And Dawson with some pace. Out of system are the Gales. Tomlinson to Auden. wide to Dawson here, and right into Burnett's breadbasket with a lot of power. We talk about that touch by Anagnostopoulos facing the net.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, that's a shot that I always love Andrew Coker doing on the McMaster side. Very strong hands and, you know, super good sense of the court. Agnostopoulos absolutely setting up Dawson beautifully there.
Great back set by the libero, Dramov, as Ryerson's out of system. And Dawson tips over. Set it wide this time to Tomlinson into the double block and recycled well by Burnett. Tomlinson through the block. Maybe some mention there on the Ryerson side of that ball, maybe touching the antenna, but no call.
Yeah, maybe a little bit. That forced quick sometimes can help you out of the woods here. Coleman sitting a little bit too deep on defense, waiting for that Tomlinson kill.
9-8, Ryerson leads here. Dakic back to serve. Spinner up and over. And out of system are the Rams, and a free ball coming. Through the pipe this time to Dakic, and no block. Goodbye, Will Otten.
I think after that, Brenda Willis is going to leave Dakic on the court for this one.
I don't think there's any substitution necessary after that touch.
You know, that's just a point that goes to show how important blocking is in this game.
You have to get at least a hand on the ball.
If you appreciate your nose.
Up by Otten. Set out wide this time to Wojcik. And out of the back row, he tips over. And that misses the back line. Loose touch by the Gales.
You know, really tough one, right? Really just putting Shearhorn in a little box there, not allowing him to extend on that arm, and he kind of took it from his shoulder. Very difficult to get the trajectory down.
Dawson this time from the service line into the net. And Ryerson Rams repay a loose error by the Queens Gales with one of their own. As it's 10-all here in the third set. Shearhorn back to serve. Floater over, up by Otten. Tight to the net and a one-handed save there by Anagnostopoulos. Out wide to Burnett. Over the block and dug up by Anagnostopoulos, who's everywhere. And through the double block go the Gales, and it's their point. And yet again, Mike Tomlinson fires away.
You know, Agnostopoulos should have been there.
What are you doing, buddy?
What are you doing?
Oh, fantastic play by him, but Tomlinson again with the answer. Pace down Broadway. Shearhorn from the service line. Out wide here, and that's Coleman off hands. Well dug up by Burnett. He'll get it back on the free. And Agnostopoulos tight to us to Wojcik. And into the hands there of Wright. And no one takes that free ball on the Rams side. And Agnostopoulos hoping for someone else to get their hands to it. And he watches it fall to the floor.
You know, a huge shout out to both setters here tonight, Wright and Agnostopoulos, absolutely playing lights out defense, as you would expect setters in the finals of OUA. But wow, what a one to miss.
Out wide to Coleman, who beats the double block. You might wonder, as a viewer, why an Agnostopoulos would watch that ball fall, but of course, he doesn't want to be the first pair of hands to touch the ball.
You know, yeah, that's just it, and that's a really great point, because watching at home, you might be, what is this guy doing? But that's just it. He's our guy to set everything up, and often if setters take that first ball, they actually get in trouble.
Meanwhile, out of system ball, Burnett can't make it work. 12 all here, side out volleyball really raining at the moment. As Reardon goes back to serve, floater over, up by Dramov. Wide here to Burnett, into the block of a Fohan, who finds the floor and celebrates. Much better, tighter block by a Fohan on that occasion.
Absolutely, you know, to seal up that block, what you want to do is you want to push those palms across. Often you think you want to jump the highest and try to get your arms across, but it's all about the palms. You don't want to be a liability at all. Ofua doing a fabulous job of using those huge mitts and absolutely sealing the deal.
13-12, the Ryerson Rams lead, and we have, uniquely to the men's game, the sweat break.
The sweat break. You know, Fraser, I remember being CIS here a long time ago before I came to Mac, and I remember I was a sweat rag girl. That was probably the highlight of my life at that point.
That's a good way to traumatize yourself, cleaning up the sweat of Nathan Groenvelt.
I almost got sat on once. It was invigorating.
Oh, 13-13 as Queen sides out. And Tomlinson goes back to serve. Third set here, teams tied at a set apiece and 13 all. Precisely the tight match you would expect for the OUA semifinals. Loose up there by Auden, it's a free. And on the third touch goes Burnett. He gets the first, and Wright gives it right back to him.
You know, always tough. It's also a home side advantage, with the light system here in Mac. You know, they are very bright. So Tomlinson throwing up this spin serve so high, he really hasn't been affected at all. We haven't seen any foot violations from him on this side. Hopefully I'm not doing one of those things where we jinx him, but you know, that is a tough thing to adjust to, and he's really been doing fabulously on the service line, if you don't count that last one.
I like your approach to the curse of the commentator. Just gloss right over it.
Just
go to the next point.
Don't worry about it.
Wojcik takes to the service line, and I won't mention anything here. Spinner coming, and
you insinuated
just misses.
It. You insinuated
just misses.
It. So here we go, one for one.
A great eye again by Dramov to really watch that one buzz right past him. 15-14. And Brenda Willis up to talk to her libero as Burnett serves. Floater up and tight to the net, and the Gales are called on the net. That was Dakic, a little too eager to party on that ball.
You know, it's always a tough play there when the ball's kind of soaring a little soft over the tape, because you expect someone to contest you. So if you don't go in with a little bit of strength, you might get beat. But if you do, you might touch tape.
Oh, it really is
a game of the senses.
A tough one to call, as Auden with a great dig here as we get back into match play. And Dawson beats Dramov, plants that right at his feet. And the Ryerson Rams take us into the third set technical. They lead 16-15, and you could really cut this one with a knife.
You know, what I want to see on this queen side, I feel as though Dramov has been a little bit quiet this game. You know, he's usually very vocal in the back, very persistent on where he's going, calling his teams and everything, and it seems a bit quiet.
Well, and you wonder if that was what Brenda Willis was mentioning to him. She was pretty eager to get up and talk to her libero a few points ago. Maybe really seems like Queens needs an emotional boost, maybe a point or two to really pull themselves back into this one, because although they only trail by a point, emotion seems to be going the way of the Ryerson Rams at the moment.
You know, that's a fabulous point, because in this game it's all about energy and it's all about emotion, as we take this roller coaster ride, it is only a 1-point spread, so you can't allow that to take over any part of your game, because it is now or never. It's the final four.
Well, the teams have retaken court here, and we'll see if Brenda Willis can really resuscitate her team here. Of course, in that opening set, it began so poorly, and Brenda Willis called a timeout, managed to really rally her troops. See if she can do the same thing here. Back to serve goes Coleman. Spinner into the tape. And the Gales get an easy gift there. Out of the technical. Back goes Scott Burnett, or Burnett the Elder, I'll call him here. Floater over, up by Dawson, and through the middle to Afoa. Does he find court? He does. Good eye there to go at the middle in the back row. As Afoa will check out, in comes Jordan yet again. A chosen service sub who's just tossing around the paddles at this point. Maybe some nerves, Amanda.
Maybe a little bit. Hopefully not, though, as he is the serving sub.
Yeah, not exactly the visual you want for the man you choose to bring in to serve. Referees discuss the change here. Hence a bit of a break.
As that happens, Dramov and Wright really talking together, as they're both the those leaders in the front and the back row right now. Maybe making a little bit of that connection, making sure that nothing else slips away.
Now, referees continue to discuss this change. And as they do, the Rams will huddle up here momentarily. Of course, all of these opportunities are moments where you can do a little bit of teaching, a little bit of instruction, some bonus timeout time.
Absolutely. Brenda Willis looks on the other side. Dustin Reed gets a little bit of time with his setter, so she might as well get a little time with Shearhorn.
Back goes Jordan, and the floater over, up by Burnett, tight to the net, saved by Wright to Dakic. set out wide this time, and that's Dawson over the block up by Dramoff. And just bumped over on the free here by Dakich. Wide to Dawson. He beats the block, but he can't beat Burnett. And Dakich kills past the block, and it's saved somehow right near the A-frames. Free ball. Wide to Dakich, at a solo block, and a great save by Jordan. Into the double block and recycled here by Anagnostopoulos. Wide to Dawson, into hands, and that falls just wide. And the Ryerson Rams explode in celebration.
What athleticism here by Dramov on the queen side. He goes up, he calls his setter off in the middle of jumping over the attack line and making that set. You know, that just goes to show that he is back in this game, but unfortunately it goes the way of the Ryerson Rams.
Jordan with the floater. Up by Burnett, and wide this time to Tomlinson. He beats the double block, and again, Tomlinson, not being too complicated, pace directly at the block. Can you handle it? And the answer has been no thus far tonight.
I like that note, not being too complicated. It's very true. He really is just going in with power.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So far from Mike Tomlinson tonight, it has not been broken. Jamie Wright with the float serve, not handled well, but a great pancake by Lucas Coleman. Keeps this one alive, but only so long that Mike Tomlinson can obliterate another ball.
You know, I gotta say, rarely does the pancake pass from one player to the next work. Usually that's a defensive play, and it just goes to show that if you give that free ball, Queens is gonna give it right back to you.
Jamie Wright from the service line gives that point back cheaply. 19-18, and a terrible time for a float serve error. Of course, we say it all the time, but if you're bringing a floater, you might as well be clean. Not that time. Anagnostopoulos over. Set this time through the pipe to Burnett, who's loose. 20-18.
You know, this is when crisp play is so important and just really getting those fundamentals. When you try and be too fancy with it, as Chris Burnett kind of did, he tried to go shoulders forward over the shoulder, kind of throwing that rotator cuff across his body. You know, it gets sticky. You can't put your full strength into it. You can't put your full topspin into it. And that's what we saw, ball flying out the back.
Well, Amanda, as I look up at the board here, most of the way through this third set, and the thing that really stands out to me is really the versatility of these Rams. Three scores in double digits, whereas if you look across the board, you see Tomlinson with 21 points, and then it really is fairly barren past there.
You know, absolutely. That is such a great observation. We see Tomlinson with 21 points all to himself, so if Ryerson can just shut that down with the block as they have been getting a bit more tactical, you're completely right. You know, you can have that hot hand, but you've got to be able to instill a little bit of confidence in the other hitters on your side as well.
And Anagnostopoulos back to serve here. And up in the backcourt, wide to Dakich, who misses that one. Loose shot by Dakich.
Maybe that's why they're throwing it out to Tomlinson, you know?
Yeah, not often that you see Marco Dakich unable to swing through the ball. I wonder, I hope that's not physical. It's not often we see that. And Anagnostopoulos again with the floater, up by Dramoff. Tight here to Shearhorn, and not saved. Great attempt by Anagnostopoulos, and again, Coleman diving around in the backcourt to no avail. Dustin Reed off the bench. Word for the officials. 21-19, the Rams lead here. Do or die time in this third set as Dakich goes back to serve. Up by Otten, but not well, and that point's going the way of the Gales. A lift called on the Rams on the second touch. That's a tough one, just a touch reaction play, Amanda. Called on the lift.
You know, surprisingly, sometimes those just work out because that's just what it is, a reaction play. You don't have a lot of time to hold on to it.
Dakich off balance on the float serve through the middle, and this rally already a little ugly. Dawson forced a set, Dramoff up. Out wide this time to Burnett, into a double block and down. It's Reardon with the interior hands on that block. He celebrates that point.
You know, that's what it's all about, these blockers. It's Dawson's job here to get that pin set and Reardon to really just close and trust where he is. And now that these guys have been starting to do that a little bit more, we've been seeing a lot more success.
with blocking for Ryerson.
Really has been a turnaround point for the Ryerson Rams. We mentioned it in the second set, really unable to block for a long period. Starting to get more technically sound. As we come out of the sweat break, it's Dawson back to serve. Up by Dramoff. Wide here to Tomlinson. He beats the block, and he beats an Agnostopoulos too. So much pace from Mike Tomlinson tonight. He's going to feel it in that shoulder.
Absolutely. 21-22. No surprise here. End of the set, and we're still only split by one.
Loose hands there by the Rams, and this will be a free. Very close to the net. And that's a loose ball by Tomlinson, who holds his head in his hands. Terrible mistake at this juncture.
You know, it's funny to think that a free can be that tactical. What a great placement. You know, right behind the body of Wright, that eliminates a lot of his vision for the outside set. You know, he had to turn completely, and they just fully got out of sorts from just simply the placement of free ball.
Well, Brenda Willis forced to call a timeout after that miscue. Her team 2 points away from going down 2-1 here at the Birds Gym. And Amanda, at this point, it has to become a matter of execution for the Queens Gales.
Absolutely. You know, they need some good passing. They maybe just need to throw it to Tomlinson to get a big swing. And they need to isolate someone else, because the blocking has been getting a lot stronger on the Ryerson side. If they completely shut down Tomlinson, it seems as though they need something else to throw to.
Well, the Gales very quick out of the timeout as the Rams continue to practice. And referees remind them that there is a limit to that timeout. Well, they go back to serve.
Tough position here for Setter Wright on the Queen side. He only has two options here and two large pin blockers on the outside.
And that serve finds the tape. Costly mistake by the Rams.
Always a tough one when you go in for that serving option and you end up missing that serve. Dustin Reed ensuring that that was okay.
Tomlinson back to serve here for the Queens Gales. Spinner incoming. Over the tape, up by Kosiba. And back to Lucas Coleman, who brings up some set points here at 24-22. Wojcik back to serve. This building getting a little louder here.
You know, right now what we're seeing is all these players on the Ryerson team are really flexing their muscles and earning the respect of the Queens players. And if they falter in any area of that, they're going to get taken.
Well, Wojcik wastes one of those set points from the service line. 24-23 as Burnett goes back to serve. And we get the icing the server technique from Dustin Reed, I believe.
Yes, icing the server, calling the timeout, and making them think about what's going to happen here. You got to wonder what Dustin Reed is really telling his players right now on this first opportunity for that match point.
Well, really, at this point, there's not too much to complain about tactically for either coach. Really just a matter of getting that first pass, getting back in the system. And if you're the Ryerson Rams, really shrugging off that mistake by one of your veteran leaders, Wojcik. The teams retake court. Very quick, business-like timeout there. Of course, Dustin Reed got what he wanted. He forced Burnett back to the bench. And now he puts that thought in the rookie's mind here on set point. Over by Burnett, up by Otten. Wide this time and tipped over. And Coleman's tip play works. Somehow, Dramoff can't get around that ball, and he's still lying on the floor, agonizing over that missed touch. As Ryerson takes it 25-23, and the Ryerson Rams lead 2-1 overall as these two teams switch over.
You know, when you get in a place like this, Final Four, OUA, you can't bring ego too much into it. Dramoff laying on the floor a little bit too long, not clapping the hands of his fellow players. That's not what you want from your leader in the back row. You know, you can definitely take that second to think about it, but it all comes back to the final goal, you know.
Well, we saw some huge shots from both sides of the court here. Dakic right through the pipe. And of course, touch plays on both corners as the blockers came back into this match. And as we get ready for set number four, our sideline reporter Kyle has some thoughts of his own.
The atmosphere is crazy. Two teams from out of town, yet fans have made the journey to Hamilton to cheer on their team because they know how big this game is. Nationals are next week. OUA's are this weekend. And if you hear to my right, the Ryerson fans are here. There's not a lot of them, but there's enough. They're equipped with everything from a bowl to a mini stick with an air horn. So they're right into this game. And the Queens fans have made the journey from Kingston. So this gym is full with fans, but I don't think it'll compete with what's gonna be here at 8 o'clock. So three sets down, we'll see how these fans impact the outcome of this match. Back to you guys at the desk.
Thank you for that, Kyle. And as we return here, Queens Gale's taking the court and we're looking at the stat sheet. And Amanda, can you explain to the viewers here what you just pointed out to me?
Holy cow, guys. You know, you look at the serving right away once you get the stat sheet. And you know, at the very beginning, we had very equal serving errors from each side. 17 serving errors from the Ryerson men tonight, only 8 from the Queens side. And this is surprising to see as the Ryerson Rams really are pulling ahead of Queens right now. But with 17 errors, you know, that could be the difference between the next set, and that could have been the difference between a 1-point spread and a little bit more of comfort within each set.
Well, it really makes you believe that the Ryerson Rams at this point must be getting the better of rally play outright, really giving back most of that set in errors. And they'll need to clean that up because they really could have really run away with that set more convincingly had they been cleaner.
Absolutely, and that's what we are going to be talking about in this last set. Who's going to be taking it? These teams are so well matched together, but is it going to be a matter of just giving it to the other side to make the mistake, or is it going to be taking it into your own hands and just killing it on offense from the baseline and from that blocking perspective?
Well, the setter and Agnostopoulos is back to get us started here in set four. Of course, the exact same rosters out here. No big changes from either side. As the setter is back. Floater incoming. Over and up by Burnett. Wide this time to Dakic, and no block up to meet him. And he goes straight at the setter in the back row and gives us a nice roar for his trouble.
Yeah, you know, sometimes those blocks are a little bit weaker at the beginning of the set once you really get into it. And Dakic is really testing his luck by going straight at the blocker there.
Burnett with the float serve. Up this time by Coleman. Wide to Wojcik off hands. And Wright gets there to set up his man Dakic on the left. Into a block. Recycled by Shearhorn. Wide to Tomlinson. Off the block and down. Yet again, the Ryerson Rams unable to really triangulate Tomlinson tonight.
You know, really difficult call there from Ottman here from the outside. You know, goes off the side of the block there, and he's got to debate whether he's going to touch it, whether it went off there, or whether he needs to curl it back in.
Meanwhile, Reardon sides out for his team with a pretty uncomplicated quick offhand. Dawson goes back to serve for the Rams. Spinner upcoming from Dawson. And he just misses. Fantastic call by the Gales, who bailed out around that ball.
Yeah, you know, you see these serving errors, but in terms of attack, Ryerson did double the percentage that Queens had last set, so it could all boil down to recovering those serving errors right at the net.
Great one-handed set by Anagnostopoulos and into a double block, and Queens repeats the trick as Tomlinson with the decisive touch, and he celebrates like he means it. Huge early point for the Gales. Jamie Wright back to serve after that giant double block. Otten up out wide here to Coleman, and he won't find hands on that occasion. He went fishing. And nothing doing for Lucas Coleman.
Not a lot of space for Coleman to go in for that attack, trying to be a little tricky carve around the block there as he had a very big block set up in front of him. That's kind of one of those points where you kind of just need to bail out your setter, tip it across the net, and recycle.
Well, 5-1 here for the Queens Gales to begin this fourth set. Dustin Reed forced to call timeout and Queens, the much cleaner team against all the odds here. Must have been something that was said in that changeover because they looked very calm.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you put that so well because they both teams walked out and you really wouldn't be able to tell which team was up, which team was down. And that's just where you get when you get these top teams in the OUA competing for the opportunity to play in the championship. You have to walk in. It's a fresh start and it's a new opportunity.
It should be mentioned here that the winner of this match is guaranteed a place at the CIS National Championship. Two automatic entries from the OUA in addition to the host berth carried by McMaster. So three of these teams in the Final Four will go. And woe to the one who isn't. 5-2 here as the Rams side out. Much needed early side out from them. Reardon back to serve. Floater over, up by Dramov. Through the middle here to Shearhorn, and the quick works to perfection.
You know, what I saw at the beginning of this set, Wright started in a different position than he did before. That means we have Shearhorn up against Ofoa more often than we have Shearhorn up against the other opposing middle on the Ryerson side. A little bit of that changeup adds a different perspective for Shearhorn, and maybe he will be more successful in the middle. Maybe that's why we haven't seen him as much going up against Ofoa. He could be a lot more successful versus Reardon.
Dakic continues to have trouble squaring up that spinner. Puts that serve into the net. Side out Ryerson. And a huge serve from the Ryerson side. Free ball here after that serve by Wojcik. Wide to him. Beats the block, but not Dakic. Ofoa into a block, and that'll take it down. Great attempt by the Queens Gales to wait out Ofoa, but they can't get their hands around that block.
Always a tricky one there. Double block going up, but on that two-step approach, Ofoa seemed to be both of them on that vertical.
Wojcik back to serve yet again. Ryerson closing this early gap. 6-4 Queens. Straight up and out wide here to Burnett. Into a double block. And that's wide. Side out for the Queens Gales. In the middle, Shearhorn back to serve. Grandma will check out. Shearhorn with the floater. Up by Otten. And set out wide here to Wojcik. Right into the tape. Uncharacteristic error from Rob Wojcik.
Always a tough call there. You have Dawson stepping up to make that set because Agnostopoulos is just too far away. Wouldn't make sense. But when you set that back ball, it needs to be a lot higher, especially when you have someone like Wojcik with their vertical. That's where the error might have played.
Service error by the Queens Gales. And another side out for the Ryerson Rams hanging around here early in set four. And Queens doing themselves no favors after that timeout with a slew of errors. Up this time, and wide to Tomlinson into a block, and that one is saved on the pancake. Wide to Burnett. Up, out wide this time to Dawson over the double block. Does he find the floor? He does.
So much effort in that one there. It looked like we had a stack of pancakes over there.
Oh, don't make me hungry here, Amanda. It's been a while since lunch. Lucas Coleman back to serve for the Rams. 8-6, the Gales lead here in set four. Oh. Loose touch there by Jamie Wright. And Dustin Reed is up out of his seat. Wide here over the hands of Dawson, but karma strikes.
Yikes, that was a close one there, Fraser. That loose ball coming off of Wright's hands really did make Reed come out of his seat, and I think maybe a couple other people still on the edge of theirs.
Well, I never envy the officials in moments like that. You have to watch the rest of a rally play out. After a bit of a, well, a little bit of a mishap from the coaching staff. Meanwhile, another loose serve. We're beginning to say that more and more often here in set number four. 9-7, Queens Gales lead. And Tomlinson back to serve. Spinner incoming. Over, up by Otten. Wide this time. And that's Wojcik beating the block right into hands, but the Gales can't control it. It's Burnett looking at his hands on this one.
You gotta love that, but what a beautiful pass. What a beautiful platform by Otten there on that pass. You know, he really held strong right in the air.
instilling some great confidence from the baseline to Agnesopoulos.
Foe with the float serve. Into system here, and that's straight to the elder, Scott Burnett. Down and off at Ryerson head. No better way to drive your point home.
You know, always a tough one. You're trying to twitch to, so the ball doesn't hit you in the face, but you really still want to keep that platform. Wojcik taking that one off a chicken wing.
Burnett with the serve, wide here to Dawson. Pass the double block, great up by Dramov, and saved. And we remain in play after a couple great saves by Dramov and Tomlinson. And Queens will take down the point as the Rams put that one into the antenna, and that is entirely work ethic being rewarded.
Absolutely. Tomlinson being super athletic in this game thus far. Great swings, and we just saw his wheels there as well.
Very tight to that bench. Teammates having a bailout in front of him. Great set that time by Anagnostopoulos, and Reardon puts it down. We want to talk about the ability to inject some pace into that ball.
Absolutely, and that's what we want to see more. Forcing that middle, keeping those blockers honest, and Agnesopoulos can do it.
Back he goes to the service line. Floater over. Wide here to Dakic, but very tight. And that goes right into the block of Lucas Coleman.
So this is that moment where Dakic really needs to look at right and say, hey man, I need that ball off a little bit. These guys are figuring it out. They're singling it. Or set the middle up, keep those blockers honest. There needs to be some small adjustment on this offense.
And Agnostopoulos with the serve. Wide this time to Dakic. Great up by Will Otten. And wide to Dawson over the block. And a great sprawling up by Dramov. Libero duel in progress. Tipped over this time by Burnett. Tight to the net. Popped up by Agnostopoulos. Wide to Dawson and a great up in the backcourt. Wide this time to Tomlinson into a double block, and that takes it down. And it's Reardon celebrating that point. Some great defense, and the Ryerson Rams finally take it in the front court.
You see these guys slowly take their form and where they're supposed to be on the court, as in rallies like that, it really does exhaust you. See a little huffing and puffing here tonight.
Agnostopoulos back to serve. Floater over, up by Dramov, and through the middle to Burnett. Takes that off the hands of Reardon and down as Queens pumps back into the lead. 12-11.
It's all about that middle play.
Seems like we've been saying it all night. 1 point, 2 point leads. Neither team able to really run away here, and that makes for some great volleyball. Well, error from the service line makes it 12 all here. Dawson takes over. Spinner coming, and right into the bottom of the tape by Dawson. Wojcik in danger on that occasion. It's dangerous up there in the front row sometimes.
Oh, man.
Jamie Wright back to serve for the Gales. Up this time by Coleman. And wide to Wojcik. Thumps that one down right in front of the setter, Jamie Wright.
Always a good tactical play having Wojcik go up. He's a very strong player, getting that cut shot to exactly where that setter is coming into on defense. When you ever have a setter on the back line serving, whenever you have a middle on the back line serving, you technically want to really put your offensive strength towards that area.
Ball wide to Tomlinson into a double block. Recycled here by the Gales. Popped over by Dakic. Up this time to Coleman on the high ball. Over the block, saved by Dramov. Tight to the net is Tomlinson. Wide here to Coleman, into the double block. And the Queens Gales somehow earn that point, really against the run of play.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you see Dramov running across the court, really making that enthusiastic play out to the side. I might change it to Dramov versus Dramov, it seems so, watching him throughout this game.
We need a hi-hat in here, Amanda. Dakic with the spin serve. Up tight to the net is an Agnostopoulos. And a foul will get the party ball into a block. And that's not coming back. What a great eye by Tyler Shearhorn.
You gotta love the chaos that ensues after a big block like that.
Both teams clearing out, one to celebrate and the other to try to run down a doomed ball. 15-13 for the Gales, looking to take this fourth set. and power in to a decisive fifth. Dakic from the service line, up by Dawson. Wide to Coleman. And from the back row, he takes it down. Only Tomlinson in front of him. And he carves around the hands of his fellow outside.
Dakic really going strong at Dawson again.
It really is an interesting thing to watch here. There's got to be some scouting behind it, because the Gales have gone at Dawson in the receive pattern time and time again tonight.
He's been taking it so well, though.
Yeah, you start to wonder if maybe it's time to change the tactic. But the Queens Gales take us into the technical here with a 16-14 lead after that service error by the Ryerson Rams.
Definitely an interesting point that early in this game we kind of had a little bit of a shout-out for both these teams for no errors, and it seems as though coming into the third, as the stakes rise, you know, you really try and bring your A game right from that baseline, and as that happens, things happen in terms of errors.
And it really becomes a matter of how many errors can you accept to be aggressive. Mm-hmm. I would argue that both teams may be a little bit too far on the error-prone side of that line at the moment. Really is hurting the Ryerson Rams here as they trail 16-14. And Amanda, you just feel they have to be cleaner overall.
Yeah, and it all comes to pros and cons there as we talk about the baseline and those missed serves. Because if you do not bring that strong serve, you might be getting something shoved down your throat right after that. And you know, both teams have been very strong on offense. We have seen that. And now it is all going to boil down to who is stronger on that block.
Well, the teams retake court here, with the Gales back to serve. It's the middle, Shearhorn at the service line. The Vuvuzela is active behind us as the floater comes up. Coleman up through the middle here to Afoa. And a nice, clean, easy side out for the Ryerson Rams. Again, when they've gone to Afoa in the middle, it has worked tonight.
You know, surprisingly, we've said that over and over, and look at the stat sheet here from last set. 7 kills, 0 errors. That's 100% chance you're going to get a kill with Afoa. Give him the ball.
Coleman with the serve up. And this one goes the way of the Gales on the net call. A loose block attempt by the Ryerson Rams. As the Gales reestablish their 2-point cushion here in the fourth set. Back goes Tomlinson to the service line. Spinner coming. Spinner over and just misses the back line. Agonizingly close. And we see this service substitution yet again, Amanda. Jordan for Afoa.
Always a tough call to be very successful on the baseline. You're usually aiming for that back third area, but it definitely makes you vulnerable to serving that ball out.
Jordan with the pretty nondescript float serve, but it eats up Dakic as he takes down the ace. 17 all. The lead has evaporated for the Queens Gales. Jordan goes back to serve again. Off tape. Handled better this time by Dakic. Out wide to Tomlinson, who beats Dawson. Plants that one in the back corner.
Makes it a lot more difficult for Coleman here on the back, as Dawson was the only blocker here up against Tomlinson. You know how quick that attack comes, so if there's not more seal, it's very difficult to defend 9x9 area of court.
Here's Burnett back to serve, and the floater beats everyone and the back line. Great eye there.
I love that when players make the decision in the air. Coleman really just pulling right away at the right moment.
That is one of those plays where you look like a hero or you look like a total clown in front of all your teammates. Set out wide this time into hands, and that's Dakic. It's a side out for the Gales. Retake the lead here at 19-18.
Gotta seal that block.
We've said it time and time again tonight. The one area, technically, where the Ryerson Rams have been loose. Scott Burnett back to serve for the Gales. Floater over. Up out wide this time to Wojcik. And against a single blocker, Robert Wojcik feasts.
Wow.
That was,
you know, sometimes
power.
You just look across the net and you say, okay, we'll go for the next one. Because what a kill.
Out wide here to Tomlinson, over the block. Up by Dawson and wide to Coleman, and he pounds that one to the floor. Beats Shearhorn on the cut shot. And now it's a Ryerson lead, 20-19.
Love watching Dawson here on the defense. Brenda Willis just called a timeout. But again, love watching Dawson on the defense here. You know, he makes that platform, he makes that pass, and then he's still looking down to see where he is in the court. And the reason why he's doing that is because it's that sixth volleyball sense. He's trying to decide how much power he needs to take out of that ball, how much he needs to add to get it up to that front row to allow Agnostopoulos to make a very good set on that one. And what a great one he did to really give him the opportunity to set up Coleman.
Really, as we've seen so far tonight, that Agnostopoulos can get an A pass to one of these players. The versatility, the athleticism of guys like Wojcik, like Coleman, like Dawson will make the best of that play almost every occasion.
Absolutely, and here we go. These guys are back on the court ready to go. It's a game to five for the Ryerson Rams, a game to six to just survive for the Queens Gales.
Dawson at the service line here to get us started after the timeout. Up this time and wide to Dakich. Over the block, saved by Otten, but he won't keep it in bounds. Right off the chest, but wide of the Queen side. 20 all here. Jamie Wright back to serve. Floater over, up by Otten. Wide to Coleman. Off the head of Shearhorn and a great one-handed save by Burnett. Tomlinson off balance and he misses hands.
You know, that's the set Coleman wants, that one right along the net but off at least 2 feet. He's got huge blockers on the outside. Standing next to them, he doesn't have as much height, but he does have the strength and the volleyball IQ to curve around it.
Well, we haven't seen miscues from Mike Tomlinson too often tonight. That was a tough ball for him to handle, but he couldn't get around it. Suddenly it's 21-20. Rams lead. Back they go. Up by Dramov here. Wide to Dakich into a double block. And a perfect time for a Boa to show up in the interior of that block. As the Rams take a pivotal 2-point lead here. And Brandon Willis is up out of the seat.
Absolutely a pivotal time. You are absolutely right here, Frazier. And this is the moment where these guys start diving. You know, they're sweating. They're getting that speed cloth out there. And it also gives them the chance to kind of take a deep breath and reset. Sometimes that tactical, gotta retie my shoe thing.
We've seen teams use it all the time. Of course, the sweat break is one of those very often used to calm a team down. Serve comes over. Wide this time to Tomlinson, he tips, and he misses hands. Tomlinson really tried to sell that play, but he won't get the call, and his team is 2 points away from being relegated to the bronze medal match tomorrow.
So what we're seeing now, this is those moments where you need a team to either do what they've been doing the whole time, stay fundamental, or they're gonna try and do too much. When have we ever seen Tomlinson pull that move off? He needs to go up, swing with no regard, be Tomlinson, be that strong, strong player that his team needs him to be right now. And none of these players can win this game alone.
Oh, absolutely. It has been a team effort. As we've talked about on the Ryerson side with their versatility and their offensive weapons, Queens will need to pass with some authority right now, drag themselves back into system. It's now or never. This opening semifinal of the OUA Final Four. Wes Kosiba back to serve yet again for the Ryerson Rams. Kosiba with the floater. Up this time by Dramov. Wide to Tomlinson and he beats the double block. And Queens staves off elimination for another point. Reardon back in and Kosiba out. Otten checks in as well. Back go the Gales to the service line. And it's Dakich with the spinner. And he goes into the tape. He's called.
You know, rather, Dakich actually went up for that spin serve, foot right on the line there. Really tough call late in the set. you don't want to risk it by trying to overstep that.
Wojcik back to serve now for the Rams. Three match points upcoming. And the spinner over the tape, up by Dramoff. Wide this time to Tomlinson into a double block and wide. As Tomlinson tools and Queens survives their first match point.
You know, no matter who you are in this gym, you can really cut the tension with a knife right now. No matter if you're emotionally invested in these teams at all, this has just been such a great game.
Up this time by Coleman. Wide to him. Beats the double block. And Queens is called on the net. And we get the most anticlimactic of finishes here for such a great match. The Ryerson Rams were headed to the OUA final and the CIS championships in a week's time, where they'll come right back here to the Birds Gym. And Amanda, they really deserve the rest they'll get as they watch the second semifinal tonight. They've done a lot of work.
Absolutely. You know, these guys will see one of the teams that are going to compete tonight. McMaster and Waterloo will go head-to-head at 8 p.m., and then they will, whoever wins, will see the Ryerson Rams.
Well, we talked about it time and time again, Amanda, about the versatility of this Ryerson Rams team. And as we look up at the scoreboard, 15 points for Wojcik, 15 points for Coleman, 12 points for Dawson, and 10 for Afoa. This is a team that really came at the Queens Gales with a myriad of offensive options and kept them off balance throughout.
Absolutely. And you look on the other side, 26 points for Tomlinson. No surprise there. He absolutely played lights out. Needed a little bit more support on the offense from the rest of his team. But maybe we will see that tomorrow.
Well, of course, this means that the Ryerson Rams are a perfect 3-0 against the Queens Gales this season. And if you're the Queens Gales, maybe in the matchup you didn't want to see here at the Final Four. But of course, they will have one more opportunity to possibly qualify for the national championships tomorrow night. And we see, of course, the Rams getting their celebration in here. And of course, the robust multimedia department at Ryerson, meaning we've got some cameras in there as well.
Exactly, and like you said before, the Ryerson Rams have been working their way back to be a team that can be really respected in the OUA, and they're there now. They have just secured a spot in the CIS. That is huge for a team. That is huge for a young team with senior members and different pieces coming up through it. And Dustin Reed, he is the coach of both the men's and the women's program. So that not only takes a toll on the team, having a coaching staff that's working day and night for the program, but just to lift this program back up to a point where they're going to be playing in the CIS championships.
Of course, the Ryerson Rams were upset at the quarterfinal stage a year ago. The year before that, arrived here at the Birds Gym, lost in the semifinal to McMaster, lost the previous year. So they've really been on the cusp of this appearance at Nationals, at this appearance in the OUA final for several years. We've often talked about them as, on paper, one of the one or two best teams in the province. But they often haven't delivered, and here tonight they really did. They had to gut it out.
And starting at 8 o'clock, we will see the marked best team in the province as McMaster takes on Waterloo.
Well, we're about to see that matchup in about a half hour's time. Of course, these two teams made the most of their time on court and their experience here with the sport court at McMaster. Of course, we'll be seeing the exact same setup in a week's time. This really is sort of the dress rehearsal for our facility staff here at Mac.
No surprise here as these guys enter the court to do their warm-up. DJ Jukebox playing Birds Flying High for his home court team, McMaster Marauders.
Well, as the teams start to switch over here, we've got our sideline reporter, Kyle, with one of the stars of the show. It's Lucas Coleman of the Ryerson Rams.
Thanks, guys. I'm here on the court with Lucas Coleman, who had 14 kills today in the semifinal game, and that's not all. He carried his team in the quarterfinals with 21 kills as well. So Lucas, what went right for you and your team today?
Today we struggled serving today, but I thought our passing was very good at key moments. And I think that really helped us relieve a lot of pressure at key times, and that went well for us today.
And how does it feel to be playing for the OUA championship tomorrow?
Oh, it's amazing. We've been waiting for this for a couple years now, so just there's no words to describe it.
And the last question, how did your little fan section over there encourage and motivate you guys to do well today?
Oh, it was great. We heard them the whole game. Queens didn't really have any fans out today, so I think them being there really helped us out.
Okay, thank you for your time. Best of luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
Back to you guys at the desk.
Well, you heard from Lucas Coleman. It has been a long time coming for the Ryerson Rams, but they are in to the OUA final tomorrow night here at the Burridge. That's 8 p.m. for them. And in the meantime, we have our second semifinal coming up. You can see the two teams getting ready to play here. It's the McMaster Marauders and the Waterloo Warriors to show who will be the Ryerson Rams opponent tomorrow night. Ladies and gentlemen, for Amanda Weldon, I'm Fraser Caldwell. We'll see you here in about a half hour. And in the meantime, enjoy a little bit of a break.